Welcome back. We are discussing two-way classification. This is another lesson we are explaining in the two-way classification. Now we discuss in this lesson the mathematical model of two-way classified data. What is the mathematical model? The linear mathematical model in two-way classification is explained as yij is equal to mu plus alpha I plus beta j plus epsilon ij. This is what the mathematical model is considered in two-way classified data. I explain one by one all the terms. What is yij? Yij is measurement or yield which is from the jth variety by applying the ith treatment, or else we can discuss in another fashion. Yij is the yield of measurement from the experimental unit by applying ith treatment and jth variety. By applying two kinds of factors, ith treatment and jth variety, that one particular treatment and another particular variety, by applying the treatment and variety, what is the measurement we are obtaining, what is the measurement we are getting, is nothing but YSA. It is nothing but YSA. YSA is a one measurement. The one yield of the crop, for example, yield of the crop from the agricultural experiment, from the experimental unit, by applying ith treatment and jth variety. For example, some fertilizer, some irrigation process, irrigation facility, etc. Right? So that is YSA. And then come over next one, mu. Mu is general mean effect. General mean effect. That's what we have discussed in the one-way classification. Similar fashion, it is nothing but mu is general mean effect here. Alpha I, it is the formula of mu I dot minus mu. Okay? And alpha A is effect due to the height treatment. Effect due to height treatment. And what is beta J? Beta J is a formula mu dot J minus mu. It is effect due to J variety. Effect due to J variety. Right? And epsilon is a, that we know, the same particular value. That is, epsilon is a, is error effect due to chance. Error effect due to chance. Error effect due to chance. Which is following, epsilon is a, which follows, IID, independently and identically distributed normally, with mean zero and variance sigma square e. This is what the picture of the mathematical model, each and every particular term. YSA is the yield from the experimental unit, from the jth variety, and by applying the ith treatment. It is our else experimental unit by applying the ith treatment and jth variety. It is a measurement from the experimental unit by applying the ith treatment and jth variety. Whereas mu, its general mean effect, it is going to be observed in the variation. And alpha I effect due to the ith treatment, and beta j effect due to jth variety, and epsilon I j error effect due to chance, and which follows a normal distribution, independently and identically distributed normally, with mean zero and variance sigma square e. So this is what the picture of the mathematical model, in which I prove two particular results and show that it will be helpful to you in the statistical analysis. What we are preparing the background of the statistical analysis, what is very crucial in the ANOVA two-way classified data, in the two-way classification, statistical analysis of the data, for which we are preparing the background. We are learning all the terms which are going to be used to get to estimate the parameters in the statistical analysis. Now we are preparing the background. We are learning all the terms, right? In which, now in this particular, the mathematical model, I explained two particular terms and two particular results for which I give you some particular formulas. Okay, right? So I consider the formula here mu is A. We consider mu is A, the particular value which independently follows a normal distribution and between 0 and variance sigma square, right? And now you consider with the help of this product what I do, and mu is A, I want to calculate the formula of mu I dot and mu dot j and mu, the three particular formulas. What is mu I dot? It is very similar to, you recollect the formula of the y bar I dot, what I have given in the previous lesson. Okay, y bar I dot, dot, j is running. How many values are in j? J is equal to 1 to h. Therefore, mu I dot is also in similar fashion, 1 by h, summation j is equal to 1 to h, mu I j. That is what I have given mu I j, one such value here I have given to you. And it's mu dot j, it is equivalent to the 1 by k summation, dot, dot is running, that is I running. How many values are there? I, k, 1 by k summation I is equal to 1 to k, mu I j. Okay? That is what the, and what is mu? Mu is nothing but it is 1 by n or k into h, summation I is equal to 1 to k, summation j is equal to 1 to h, mu I j. This also can be written as, I have written clearly in the formula here, or else the frame formula is 1 by k, summation I is equal to 1 to k, mu I dot. Or the same formula is also computed as 1 by h, summation j is equal to 1 to h, mu dot j. So these are the formulas for mu, mu I dot, mu dot j. So you see here mu, 1 by kh, kh means capital N. Capital N is nothing but k into h. So kh, summation I is equal to 1 to k, j is equal to 1 to h, mu I say. Or else 1 by k summation I is equal to 1 to k, mu I dot. That's what I have explained in the y bar dot dot and y bar dot j formula there. Also I have explained very clearly that how mu I dot, well, you take 1 by h inside and so that 1 by h summation j is equal to 1 to h mu I j, because h is a constant we can take inside. So therefore 1 by h into summation j is equal to 1 to h mu I j is nothing but mu I dot. It is mu I dot. Summation I is equal to 1 to k mu I dot. Summation I is equal to 1 to k here and 1 by k. So therefore 1 by k summation I is equal to 1 to k mu I dot we can write. And similarly 1 by h summation j is equal to 1 to h mu dot j also we can. Right. So the which of the formulas? Have you understood the formulas? So now what I prove in this is summation I is equal to 1 to k alpha I is equal to 0 and summation j is equal to 1 to h beta j is also 0. These are the two particular values I prove which are zeros. Summation that whatever the summation values, that is what the definition we have considered, that we consider in the null hypothesis all the treatments of x are same. So which means it is nullified, the value, that is what summation alpha is equal to 0. All the treatment of x are same, that's what we consider. For which I am proving here summation I is equal to 1 to k alpha is 0, summation I is equal to 1 to k, what is alpha I? Mu I dot minus mu, that's what I have considered. Have given the formula in the alpha I, which summation alpha I have taken, I prove it 0, with summation alpha I, alpha is equal to mu I dot minus mu. So take the summation, for summation I is equal to 1 to k, summation I is equal to 1 to k, mu I dot minus summation I is equal to 1 to k, mu is equivalent to b. What is summation I is equal to 1 to k, mu I dot? Refer here the formula of mu. The mu, the formula is 1 by k summation I is equal to 1 to k mu I dot. So if you want to take the value of summation I is equal to 1 to k mu I dot, it is, you can take the k value left hand side. K into mu is nothing but k into mu is nothing but summation I is equal to 1 to k mu I dot. So therefore it is k into mu minus summation I is equal to 1 to k mu. Mu is a constant, does not depend on summation I. Therefore, it is the, how many values are there? K into mu, k, I is equal to 1 to k, so k into mu, so therefore, this is 0. Similarly, summation j is equal to 1 to h beta j. Have you understand the value here? What I have proved? Right? Similarly, summation j is equal to 1 to h beta j is mu dot j minus mu. You can easily prove. Why need not to prove here? And therefore, if you take a summation, summation j is equal to 1 to h, it is mu dot j minus summation j is equal to 1 to h, it is mu. And which is, you refer the next formula. You have summation j is equal to 1 to h mu dot j. You refer the next formula. So, 1 by h summation j is equal to 1 to h mu dot j. Therefore, it is nothing but h into mu. Therefore, it is h into mu minus j is equal to 1 to h mu. Mu is a constant. Does not depend on summation j. Therefore, it is h into, is also h into mu is equal to 0. So, therefore, summation I alpha is 0, summation j beta j is 0. Remember, very clearly, summation I is equal to 1 to k alpha I is 0, summation j is equal to 1 to h beta j is 0. So, these are the two values I have to prove in this particular mathematical model, up to a classified data, right? So, here it is 1. I have given the student formulas. You please read the formulas. Y bar I dot, y bar dot j, y bar dot dot, and pi dot, t dot j, and g the Van Brodel. All the formulas you please read and prepare for the calculation of the two-way classified data, right? So in which we have in this class, in this lesson, we have learned mathematical model of two-way classification. Thank you.